Hey there, everyone. Ventia here, and welcome back to Star Wars Battlefront 2. We just, pretty much witnessed Order 66 or something. So, hey, let's go kill Jedi. It's that time where we go kill the Jedi. But, fuck Jedis. Me and all my homies hate Jedis.
What I remember about the rise of the Empire is how quiet it was. During the waning hours of the Clone Wars, the 501st Legion was discreetly transferred back to Coruscant. It was a silent trip. We all knew what was about to happen, what we're about to do. Did we have any doubts? Any private, traitorous thoughts? Perhaps, but no one said a word. Not on the flight to Coruscant, not when Order 66 came down, and not when we marched into the Jedi Temple. Not a word.
Okay, so I'm starting to go with the regular guy for now. I feel like at some point,
the fall of the Jedi is at hand.
We have been directed by the shotguns are good.
Authority to wipe out the insurgent Jedi Order that threatens our great empire. Our first objective is to capture the Council Chamber. Lord Vader will be our field commander. Let's keep the Jedi low and move out.
Get fucked. God, you ever just get a rocket dude right in your face? Yeah, I remember this being quite a problem back when me and my buddy used to speedrun this game on Xbox during co-op runs. Like, just this particular, like, we just get trolled so much. Yeah, that's a thermal detonator. We are just surrounded by fucking thermal detonators. Okay, well, now's the fucking time to push. God damn. Fuck out of here. Don't spawn in here unless you're dropping me health. Which, honestly, I'm not that terribly, you know. I'm well off on health. What is the opposite of bad? Whatever. I'm not doing bad on it. God.
Attention, troops. Double time to the library. The Jedi are attempting to destroy the library's holobooks. In direct defiance of command. Stop them.
Ooh. Ooh, that was some shit. Oh, guess we can't open this door. Thought that was the way to go. I mean, I know there's a giant gaping hole over here of the library, but maybe it's just not open in the story right now. Make it double back.
Stop the destruction of the Jedi holobooks. If you can keep at least one of the bookcases intact for at least 2 minutes, command can scan the contents of the library.
Yeah, at this point, it's pretty much just pick your poison, top floor or bottom floor. Because I think it's a multi-floor situation where all the books are. Or it might just be, like, pick one bookcase to try and defend. Watch out for those lightsabers. Maybe those Jedi seem to just be hardcore honking up on the second floor there. Really kind of wish there was a control point here. So I could switch to a man with a shotgun. Oh fuck. Well, I guess I get my fucking wish. Come on now. Shotgun. Yes, there is one right here. You spawn camping bitch! Are you joking? Kill the Jedi scum. Fuck you. Fuck you. Oh god, they're blocking. Oh fuck. Okay, it's time to switch to the shotgunner and we're fucking out of here.
Attention troops, double time to the library.
I got the infinite sprint on the way up there the first time.
In direct defiance of command. Stop them.
But I won't be able to get it again. Oh come on, come on. So fucking slow.
Stop the destruction of the Jedi holobooks. you can keep at least one of the bookcases intact for at least 2 minutes. Command can scan the contents of the library.
Okay, so I can repair a bookcase. So as long as I, like, this is probably the best one. I mean, I don't know, now all the cover's kind of gone. The real problem is that these fucking assholes deflect bullets sometimes. I guess I should really just, like, save my ammo for the Jedi. Yeah, like, if these guys can just do me that one solid of getting rid of the cannon fodder. I mean, I don't have to, like, respawn. Like, God, that fucking spawn camping bitch. Okay, this is looking real good. There might be one more wave of Jedi, if I remember correctly. Well, regardless, there's still one around. Okay. Alright, there we go. Now that I've got my bearings and didn't get fucking spawn camped. And switch your shotgun right away. One much better. Two. One. Now give me Annie boy.
Efficient. Your next objectives are a pair of holocrons, rumored to contain the souls of sith and Jedi knowledge. The first one is located on the comm room. Retrieve it and bring it to the veranda.
Forgot about. See, I was thinking about this part where I have to go over here. Just give me the fucking run, brother. I just want to infinitely sprint. It'll make literally everything. Look, try me. Dumbass. Little bitch. Uh-oh. Okay, we're good. Oh, we're not good. All right, time to run. I just need to run. Give me the fucking sprint, brother. Nope. Okay, there was a third one, but we're good. All right, now it's time for Annie boy.
Chamber. You must defeat this Jedi and bring this holocron to the veranda drop-off point.
Right now. Get fucking owned. Oh, come on, please let me run. Please. I'm struggling right now with movement.
Secured, we can deal with the remainder of the Jedi here. Execute the three Jedi Masters who have poisoned the minds of their impressionable students against the Empire. Let them bear witness to the cost of rebellion.
Like, I'll even kill the apprentices too.
Primary mission objectives complete. The Jedi Temple has been secured.
That's a fun mission when you don't get fucking spawn camped by Jedi, assholes. This is why the Empire really started getting at him.
With the fall of Coruscant and the illumination of the traitorous Jedi, Palpatine's rise to power was complete. In recognition of our service and loyalty to the Emperor, the 501st were placed under the direct command of Lord Vader. Armed with deadly new weapons,
blazing new ships and shiny new armor. Our presence let the galaxy know that the days of the old Republic were well and truly over. We were establishing a new era, an era of order and peace.
We did it, fucking Jedi. Cowards, a lot of them. Why are we doing this again? Man, I already had it muted once. Am I being muted again? I gotta read more? Do I even have to read the word Star Wars? I mean, they never read this shit anyway, so I'm doing you guys a fucking service, alright? I'm lending you my voice. My impeccable voice acting ability. To say words like, Rise of the Empire. The Old Republic has fallen. Emperor Palpatine has created a new galactic empire to rule in its place. Darth Vader, Dark Lord of the Sith, has taken command of the elite division of troopers known as the 501st. Now known across the galaxy as Vader's Fist, the 501st strive to establish order in the name of the Galactic Empire. Can I, like, just turn a knob to, like, just so I can, you know, speed up a little bit so I can read it? On the once peaceful planet of Naboo, the Emperor orders his newly armored stormtroopers to stifle the seeds of rebellion in a diplomatic manner befitting the new empire. Like I said, like, at a certain point, it's just kind of like you have bad eyes because of the resolution of this. Man, I gotta say, it was a very bold choice for them to put the Wii Shop music in there for the Star Wars thing. I don't know, that's really bold. They didn't go with the original score for some reason. Go ahead and save that shit. Naboo, Imperial Diplomacy. Well, sure, let's just do it. God, that guy looks like a complete asshole.
During the rise of the Empire, the Emperor's home planet of Naboo rapidly established itself as a major irritant. After a number of Naboo's ambassadors were sent home in various states of dismemberment, her newly elected queen broke off diplomatic ties and began exploring military options. Clearly, it was time for a regime change. A change that would be affected by the 501st, now under the direct command of Darth Vader. Our orders were simple. To infiltrate the city, take out their leader, sending a clear signal to other potential troublemakers in the Empire.
I love that stuff, man. Fuck him up.
Welcome to the capital city of Theed. Tonight, we will be performing a radical destabilization of the Theed government via the elimination of their queen. She is heavily guarded in the central plaza by a group of Jedi and an auto turret grid. In order to defeat these defenses, we must set up a perimeter around the central plaza and shut down the auto turret grid. Careful, soldier. Your numbers are few. And the mission's success rests on your shoulders.
Okay, well, see how he fucking narrated a novel there? I'm not gonna change my FOV, even though it is trying to drive me crazy. I don't know why. How the fuck am I supposed to see what's behind me? You know? Like, I don't have that owl head anymore. I also just apparently can't aim worth a dick right. Oh, the crosshair's fucked up. Right. That's a thing. I guess I'm just gonna explain this and I'm just gonna do it. But yeah, with this whole widescreen thing, it's the same thing with Outcast, but Outcast is a little more annoying because of how the crosshair works. Shit ain't centered. You can see it's like slightly
now
to the right.
To the Embassy Plaza. Move out.
Remember this stage kind of being a bit of a pain too back in the old speedrunning days. Let's fucking pick that one thing up. You guys have fun over there. I'm gonna check infinite and sprint and run over here. But I'm like not paying attention because I'm trying to shoot shit now.
Watch out, soldier. The auto turret grid is still online. Keep you and your men out of the central plaza until we can find a way to shut down the turret grid.
Look, I'm sure we'll be fine, Daddy-O. No need to yell at me about it. You really just hopped in there, you dumb bitch. Okay. Now we are in fucking, essentially almost home clear. That's not the word. Phrase, rather. Alright. Home free. I got that guy.
So far, so good. Now capture the guard post past the embassy. If you need some extra firepower, we've managed to sneak a tank for you at the embassy command post.
I feel like that tank was good in speedrun, but I think, oh yeah, sir, there are some vehicles, which is unfortunate. But you know what? It sounds like it's just trying to fuck my buddies up. Yeah, I know I'm like kind of surrounded in a cone-esque pattern right now. Yeah, okay, yeah, that guy was just fucking bugged out over there. Alright, now it's time for Jedi though, right?
Now we must destroy the auto turret grid console, clearing access to the central plaza. Destroy it, and the Queen will be ours.
For the Empire!
Okay. Easy.
The Queen's personal Jedi bodyguards have broken from the palace. Destroy them.
Yeah, this is where the vehicle was good for. Because these guys just start fucking charging you, you just you give them a little bit of a beat down with the vehicle, you know what I'm saying? I should be really careful, because I have to reload this thing. I'm out of ammo. There's a gonk droid close nearby. Alright. Fucking masterful. Literal god right here. Okay, they're over there. Okay, I feel comfortable with that amount of ammo. Way to just almost roll right back into your own grenade. Damn, how far is that boy? Is he behind the... Oh, fuck, he's like all the way over there. This guy, though. Oh, of course she would.
The Queen and her royal guard are trying to escape. Quickly. You must eliminate the Queen at all costs.
Man, these guys are really picking bad times to jump. Look, I have to go all the way back over here now. Can I get the sprint? No. That vehicle is just... like... Jesus Christ.
We need more troopers like you.
Oh, get fucked.
You have performed a great service for the Empire. The Queen's death will serve as an example to other nascent rebellions, saving countless lives.
Yeah, we'll see how that one works out for you, buddy. Well, yeah, the message ain't too bad. It's just, you really gotta be careful about the Jedi.
With the Queen eliminated, Naboo quickly fell in line. It was the first time the 501st was called upon to adjust a planet's government. But it wouldn't be the last. Within months, the 501st gained a well-deserved reputation as Vader's Fist.
Boy, now time for that 4-3 funness again. Every time it switches, it's just like, good, Cody Overload. Well, next time, looks like we're going to Mustafar. But until then, I'm Trentia, and you guys have a good day.